Hello friends, welcome to my channel Technical Arcwen. Today's topic, number system part 4. So go for it. Now the topic is conversion from other number system to decimal. Okay, now and in the case of fraction, okay, means the number should be fraction. So binary to decimal at first we are going on, and the example is given 0.01, which is given in binary, and we want to convert into decimal. Okay, so before we doing that, we first need some another information. Okay, now this table represents some information and it should be important when we convert from binary to decimal, or from octal to decimal, or from hexadecimal to decimal, where the number is fractional. So if we think this is a point, means the decimal point is there, and this is the position. Actually in left side we got the pure number part, and we in the right side we got the fractional part. Okay, so these are the position 0 1 2 3 4, and there is a -1 -2 -3 -4. Okay, so what is the position value? So this example is given for binary. So the position value before point is that 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 4, and going on in that way. And after the decimal point, what it? 2 to the power -1, 2 to the power -2, 2 to the power -3, 2 to the power -4, and similarly going on. So what is the quantity representation? So this position 2 to the power 0 means 1, 2 to the power 1 means 2, 2 to the power 2 means 4, 2 to the power 3 means 8, 2 to the power 4 means 16, and similarly going on. And 2 to the power -1 means 1 by 2, 2 to the power -2 means 1 by 4, 2 to the power -3 means 1 by 8, 2 to the power -4 means 1 by 16. Similar case for octal is 8 to the power 0, 8 to the power 1, and going on. And for hexadecimal, 16 to the power 0, 16 to the 1, and going on. 16 to the power -1, 16 to the power -2, 16 to the power -3, and similarly going on. Okay, so for this example, so what will be the calculation? So we take 0 into 2 to the power -1 plus 1 into 2 to the power -2. Okay, so this rule will be followed according to the previous table. Okay, result will be 0.25 and base will be 10. Okay, so 0.01 in binary, when it convert into decimal, the result will be 0.25 and base should be 10. Okay, in the same manner, octal to decimal. Okay, number is a fraction, so what the procedure? Start from just after the decimal point. So what is the calculation? 5 into 1 by 8 plus 4 into 1 by 64, and after that we get 0.625 plus 0.0625. If we add these two number, we got this. Okay, so the result will be 0.6875 base 10. 0.54 in octal, when it converted to decimal, the result will be 0.6875 in decimal. Okay, now we convert from hexadecimal to decimal, where the number is fractional. Okay, so example is 0.C4, base is 16. So what we do? C into 16 to the power -1 plus 4 into 16 to the power -2. We know in representation of hexadecimal, C will be represented by 12. So 12 into 1 by 16 plus 4 into 1 by 256. Okay, so result will be 0.75 plus 0.015625. If we add these two number, we got 0.765652. So this will be the result, and it will be converted in decimal. So this is a hexadecimal number which is converted into decimal and should provide the base 10. Okay, now we are converting decimal to binary, where the both number is present, means the pure number is also there and the fraction number is there, means the number is 12.25 in decimal, and we want to convert it into binary. So what we do? We do the previous operation separately, means we do for operation for 12 in that way, and we do 0.25 operation in that way. So what the procedure? So we just do this in that way, means divided by 2 each and every, divided by 2, and we got the quotient and remainder, quotient and remainder. And what will be the output from bottom to top? So 1100, okay. And in case of fraction, what we do? Now we are just multiplied by 2, and each and every step only the fraction part will be taken for the next calculation. And when we got the 0 in the fractional part, stop calculating, and the value should be from top to bottom and should be the pure number. So what will the part? 0.01, because 0 and 1 is there, and 0.01. So we got this from this conversion 12, and we got this from the conversion of 0.25. So final result will be, just combine these two, so 1100 1100 0.01. so this will be your final answer. Okay, in the same manner we can convert from decimal to octal and decimal to hexadecimal. Now you convert from binary to decimal, where both numbers are present, means the pure and the fraction, means 1100.01 in binary we want to convert into decimal. So we do in two part in a single line. What we do? We are just multiply by the increasing power of 2, and we are just multiplying by decreasing power of 2. Okay, and after that we are just get the result. 2 to the power 3 is 8, 2 to the power 2 is 4, 0 and 0. This part will be 0 and this part will be 1 by 4. Okay, and after that we got 8 plus 4 will be 12, and 1 by 4 will be 0.25. So final result will be 12.25. So 12.25 will be in decimal. If we convert this number in decimal, so the output will be 12.25 in decimal. So similar manner, if we convert from octal to decimal or from hexadecimal to decimal, the same manner will be followed. So in case of octal, it will be 8 increasing power and 8 decreasing power, and in case of hexadecimal, it should be 16 increasing power and 16 decreasing power. Okay, I hope you have understood this topic, so keep watching. Thank you.